Hello everybody, welcome to the algorithm course. In this video, I'm going to discuss the job search process. In this process, we have to take care of these five steps in general. First, we have to make sure that the array is already sorted. Second, we have to evaluate the optimal interval size, which is equal to root n, and n is the number of elements that you have. Third, we have to jump to the elements with indices that are multiples of the step size, calculated in step 2. And then we have to notice that the jump would stop when the jump interval contains the target. Finally, we just perform the linear search on the interval that makes our jump stop. And we have to notice that we have to find out the optimal jump size. And we can find it by considering the worst case of jumps. What is the worst case in the jump search? It happens when the target is at the rightmost index of the entire array. And at that time, the array length is equal to n, and the interval size is called m, for example. If we have m and n, we can find out the number of interval jumps, which is equal to n over m. And after we have found the interval that contains our target, we have to do additional jumps one by one, so that we do the linear search process. And the additional jumps required is m minus 1. And in this case, we just add the first value, which is n over m, and the second value, which is m minus 1. So the total number of jumps required to reach the target is equal to n divided by m plus m minus 1. After we have found the number of steps to jump, we can find out the optimal step size, m. First, we have to let the function of m, which is equal to the number of jumps required in the previous slide. And then we take the first derivative of this function, and then we equate the first derivative to zero. And after some algebraic manipulation, we find that m is equal to root n. That means the step size to jump in the jump search process is equal to the square root of the length of the array. So we can put this particular value of m into the second derivative of the function, and we can see that when we really do so, we find that the second derivative at this particular value of m is larger than zero. That means the function is reaching the minimum at m equals root n. Now let us see an example. Suppose I want to find 54 from these values which are already sorted. Also, the indices are given. And according to the previous equation, we need to find out the jump size, which is equal to square root of 10, where 10 is the length of the array. And since root 10 is not an integer, we just take the integer part of this value, which means that m is now 3. Now we start with the first element with index 0, and the index can be called current. And the value at this current index is now 4. And of course, 4 is smaller than our target, which is 54. And now we have to jump by m equals 3 steps, which is obtained at the beginning of our search process. And after the jump of 3 steps, we find that the current index becomes 3. And at this index, the value is now 13. And of course, 13 is still smaller than 54, which means that we haven't reached the target yet. We can jump further. Now we jump by 3 more steps. Now the current index becomes 6. And at this current index, the value of the array is 45. And of course, 45 is still smaller than our target, which is 54. It means that we can jump further. Now we jump by 3 more steps. Now the current index becomes 9. And at this current index, the value is 59. But now, the value is larger than our target. That means we cannot really jump so far away from the previous intermediate value, which is 45. Now it means that the current index has to turn back to the previous value, which is obtained by subtracting 3 from the index. So now we have current equals to 9 minus 3, which is 6. That means we turn the current index back to the previous value. And from now on, we are not allowed to do big jumps, but now we can do small jumps. That means we go one element by one element. Now we go one to the right of the previous current index, and now the current index becomes 7. And at that index, the value is 51. 51 is still smaller than 54. It means that we can still jump further. Now we jump by one more element so that the current index becomes 8. And now the current index gives me a value of 54, which is equal to the target. In this case, we can really find out the element from the given array. So the search is done and we can really find it out. Now let us see another example. Now we want to find out 30 from the given array, which is already sorted. And we have to determine the optimal step size first, which is equal to 3, because we have 10 elements and the square root of 10 is 3. And when we take the integer part of it, we have 3 as the number of elements to jump through. Of course, we have to start with the current index, which is 0. And in this case, the value obtained by this current index is 4. 4 is smaller than 30, so we can expect that we can jump further. How many steps to jump? We jump by 3 steps according to the previous calculation. And now the current index becomes 3. At this index, the value is 13. And of course, 13 is still smaller than 30, which is our target. It means that we can jump further. Now we jump by 3 more steps, which means that the current index is now 6. And at this index, the value is 45. But 45 is actually larger than our target. That means we cannot really jump so far away. We have to jump back. It means that now we have to turn our current index back to the previous value. How can we do so? We just subtract 3 from the current index. So now it is updated to 3, which is equal to 6 minus 3. And all the big jumps are already finished. What we can do is do some small jumps. One element by one element. Now the current index is changed to 4 because I just add 1 from the previous current index. At this index, the value is 21. And 21 is still smaller than our target, which is 30. It just means that we can jump further. Now the current index is already updated to 5. The value corresponding to this index is 34. But this value is actually larger than our target. It means that the target doesn't really exist in our sorted array. So now we have no way but to say that the search fails. That means the target cannot be found. Thank you for walking through the algorithm with me. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions at the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.